became the second fastest athlete in history, running 8:59.97. Habiba Gharibi is the Tunisian defending Olympic champion, but Hayvin Chepkemoy only finished 0.04 of a second behind Jebet, the Kenyan who now represents Bahrain in that great run in Eugene. The two of them have the five fastest times in the world this year, and on paper, from what we've seen in 2016, they are both 10 seconds faster than Emma Coburn, the American. It's packed with talent, this one. My goodness me. Well, that's a first. A false start in the final of the women's 3,000-metre steeplechase. Well, there's a first for everything. I sincerely hope, that no one is going to be disqualified. There was an athlete who stepped over the line. I think it was one of the Ethiopians. It may well have been Etanesh Diro, actually, who was reinstated in the race. Interesting to see what the starter decides to do here. Well, thank goodness for that. It's a warning. Jeepers creepers. It was Diro. Well, reinstated for the final after falling and almost disqualified after the first step. So at the second time of asking, after a world first false start in a global final of the 3,000 metre steeplechase, we are at last underway. And it's Emma Coburn now of the United States leading, with Ruth Jebet of Bahrain in second place, and also right up there is Hayvin Chepkemoy, the Kenyan. And the Bahrainian and the Kenyan have had real duels over the course of this season, and the three fastest women in the world this year are right there at the very front. This is a mouth-watering race in prospect, and I guess the question is, if Jebet decides to front run this, how early is she going to go?
Garibi's got herself up into a nice spot. She's up behind the Kenyans in about seventh place. Didn't handle the water jump all that well. About three places behind her, the blonde Australian Genevieve Lacaz, who got herself out the back early, worked herself up into the middle of the field. She generally likes to try and run up the front, but the pace is pretty hot up there. And some of these runners already starting to feel the pinch. They're really starting to string out. They've kicked up a pretty hard lap here, and they're making a move at the front. And the Kenyans are hanging on, well, at least two of them are. But this pace is really hot now. They have decimated the field with a sprint here. And there's a runner down at the back of the field as well. And that is the runner in 12-12, and that is Schlumper.
Well, we were asking the question less than a lap ago, when will Ruth Jebet decide to go? The answer is now. This is a really, really bold, brave bid for glory with five laps still remaining. Hayvin Chepkemoy is in hot pursuit. Also still in the mix is Beatrice Chepkoech, and Emma Coburn has become a little bit detached in fourth, but she's got a gap back to fifth. So Ruth Jebet, the world junior champion 2 years ago, the Asian Games winner 2 years ago, she's had a huge improvement this year. She's become the second fastest athlete in history. And the duel that we were hoping for is beginning to evolve, because it's Hayvin Chepkemoy of Kenya who leads her compatriot, Beatrice Chepkoech. But can they catch her? And in the other subplot, can Emma Coburn manage to close the gap on the two Kenyans in front of her and get in the mix for a medal? Well, we saw Almaz Ayana going very hard very early in the women's 10,000 metres, and it is unusual to see this in a major championship, but what a display of confidence from the youngster Ruth Jebet. She is desperate for this gold medal. That was a glimpse of Emma Coburn. She's just going over the barrier on the right of picture in fourth, and look how spread out they are, despite the fact that there's still four laps to go. This is a massive, massive bid for a golden moment here from Ruth Jebet.
They went the first kilometre in 3:05.93. They'll smash that in the second kilometre. We'll wait for that time to come up. It seems as though already this far from home, the medals are decided, because Coburn's got herself about 30 metres off the back of Chepkowicz, who is in the bronze medal position at the moment. Jepkemoi in the silver medal position, but it's all Jibet. Her lead is 30 metres. How long can she maintain this pace?
Well, that is the question. Jibet is miles clear at the moment. Hyvin Chepkemoi is in second. Chepkowicz of Kenya third. And maybe, as Diro, who was reinstated in the race, she's a very, very tired figure. They're unbelievably spread out here. Jibet is pouring on the pressure down the back straight. That win in Eugene, running inside 9 minutes, only the second athlete in history to do that. 2.54. 2.54 for the second kilometre. That is why she has made this race look like the tail end of a 10,000 metres. She has blown the field apart here, including the woman behind her in second place, who just stumbles a little bit coming out of that water jump, Hyvin Chepkemoi, who's the third fastest athlete in history. And I think Coburn's got a chance of the bronze here, because Beatrice Chepkowicz in third, right on the very left-hand side of your picture there, has become detached from Chepkemoi, and I think she'll start to tire, and Coburn can sense she's got a shout of a bronze medal here. But this is quite some way to go for your first senior global title. World junior champion, last year finishing outside the medals in the World Championship, but this is a demonstration of just how quickly this woman has emerged on the top of the leaderboard. And Coburn has gone into third.
And the difference between the first K and the second K, just a mere 11.8 seconds. This has been an extraordinary acceleration from Jibet. And she's got the gold medal in her keeping. All she has to do now is stay upright. And Coburn has put herself into a position not only where she might get the bronze medal, she might get the silver medal. The gap between herself and Chepkemoi is down to about 12 metres. So it's race on over the last couple of laps.
And we need to watch the clock here as they come up towards the bell. That second kilometre of 2.54 has split the field apart. And there may well be a big battle for silver. Ruth Jibet takes the bell in the final of the women's 3,000-metre steeplechase. She could run under 9 minutes here. She would need a last lap of around about 68-plus change, but she's still accelerating down the back straight. Hyvin Chepkemoi is in second place with Emma Coburn running the race of her life in third. And could the American overhaul the Kenyan? They're going to have a race of their own for the silver medal, because out front it's Ruth Jibet, stumbles a little bit into that barrier as Coburn moves up onto the shoulder of Hyvin Chepkemoi, who says, no, if I'm not going to win, it has to be the silver. I've been the second best athlete in the world this year. Let's watch the clock. This is so fast. Surely we can't see another world record in this stadium. 8.58.81 is the mark set by Gulnara Galkina in 2008. Chepkemoi's winning the battle for the silver at the moment. This is so quick. She's now beginning to tire. But Ruth Jibet is going to become the Olympic champion. So close to the world record, but she just misses it. But she runs inside 9 minutes. One of the greatest performances we've ever seen. Hyvin Chepkemoi does get the silver. A brilliant bronze for Emma Coburn. But that was a race dominated and dictated by one woman who cannot believe what she's achieved. She went within a whisker of breaking the world record. It's a new area record, a new Asian record. And she is one of the greatest athletes we've ever seen over this distance, and she's done it with such bravery, and she's won that gold medal by 8 seconds. That was incredible bravery, and what a moment for her to remember.
And all of that at the tender age of 19. We are going to be seeing her for years and years to come. The replay, if we see it, will show that Chepkemoi probably got the silver medal at the water jump, because Coburn had the momentum at the water jump and had a bit of a stumble, just wasn't able to continue it. Chepkemoi was able to take the advantage then, but no wonder she is slumped. And here is the unforgiving nature of the steeplechase, and that was the runner at the back of the field in Schlumper, who went down. She didn't actually fall at the barrier. She was brought down by clipping another runner. But here's the winner through the water jump, and no doubt looking at the clock and hoping that those tired legs would carry her there almost in world record time. It wasn't to be, but it's still a scintillating performance from the 19-year-old from Bahrain.
She was so, so close to capping it all off with the fastest time we've ever seen. It is the second quickest performance in history, faster than the sub-9-minute run she produced in Eugene. Well, maybe we were being greedy, hoping for another world record after Wade van Niekerk's exploits in the Olympic Stadium. Ruth Jebet headed into that final lap with a chance of doing an almost unthinkable double. She is the Olympic champion. It was the fastest time she's ever produced, and a lovely little tap on the cheek there from Paul Turgat. She came within a whisker of adding the world record to the Olympic title, and surely it is only a matter of time before Ruth Jebet becomes the world record holder. She's still only 19 years of age.